Hello, I'm Hans van der Kwast, Senior Lecturer at IHE Delft Institute for Water Education. In this video, I'm going to show you how to calculate the topographic wetness index. The topographic wetness index is also known as the compound topographic index, which is a steady-state wetness index. It is commonly used to quantify topographic control on hydrological processes. The index is a function of both the slope and the upstream contributing area per unit width orthogonal to the flow direction. We can apply the topographic wetness index to whole catchments and subcatchments, but also to parcels. In this example, I will apply it to a parcel. The first thing we need to do is to calculate the slope of this digital elevation model. In the main menu, we go to Raster, Analysis, Slope. There we can choose the Zevenbergen-Thorn formula instead of the Horns one if you have more smooth areas. If you have steep areas, you don't check the box. You can check this box. And we want slope in degrees. So we'll choose an output folder to save the file. And let's call it slope degrees. And then we can really run the algorithm. You can see that it uses the GDAL-DEM function. Let's do a bit of styling. We can see already in the map canvas that we lose the sides that is inherent on these kind of calculations. So it's better to choose a larger area than the area you need. So if we apply some styling, we can see already which areas are steeper and which are flatter. The next step is to correct this slope map in such a way that we don't have zeros in the map. So therefore we go to raster calculator. This is needed because later we take the logarithm, the natural logarithm. So we start with the bracket. We add slope in degrees. And we say when it's less than zero or equal to zero that we have to correct it. So we do times one. And for the other values, we keep the slope. And we call this one slope degrees. Modified. We run it and we can copy the style. There it is. And now we need to convert it to radians. So we go back to the raster calculator. Convert it to radians, we use 0.01745, and then it's slope radians.diff. We can also style this layer, single band pseudo color, color ramp, invert it so the higher slopes become red. So the next step is to calculate the upslope contributing area. And we can do that with the flow accumulation tool from Saga. As an input, we choose our DTM. We keep the default fill sinks temporarily. And we save it to an output file, which we call upslope area. This will basically calculate for each pixel the contributing upslope area. So it's done, so we can also style this one. and we can keep the red to blue ramp, but maybe we can use another way of dividing the classes to get a bit more contrast. Now the final step is to apply the topographic wetness index equation, which starts with a natural logarithm, few brackets. We add the upslope area, and we need to correct it for the pixel size. In this case, we have a 5-meter digital terrain model, so we multiply it by 5. And then we need to divide it by the tangent of the slope in radians that we previously calculated. And we can save the output as twi.tif. And when we run it, we have our topographic wetness index. We can style it to make more sense out of the contrast. And we can keep the red to blue ramp, as we see here, and this will give us the wetter and the drier areas in this parcel. There are some other tools in QGIS to calculate topographic wetness index, but this is the basic equation that you can simply build up in the raster calculator. The other tools you can find under the Saga tools.